how to create your own email domain address for free. What's up, guys? Amy here. So you bought a new domain and want to set up your own business email address like info@yourdomain.com and check all your emails coming to that email address in Gmail because everyone uses Gmail these days. No worries, I've got you covered in this step-by-step tutorial. Let's do this. All right, guys, I'm going to assume that you already bought your domain at a domain registry and have hosting. If you don't have a domain yet, I recommend using Namecheap and Porkbun. These are the two places that I buy my domains at. In terms of hosting, I use SiteGround, and I'll leave links with coupons and discounts to these services in the description area below. Step one in the process is creating a Gmail account. I'm going to leave a link below for you to arrive to the new Gmail account signup page that you see here. Now, you could use your existing personal Gmail account, but I recommend you create another Gmail account for business-related emails to keep everything separate. This will make it easier later down the track if you need to have staff checking emails on your behalf. So, guys, you just go through all the steps to set up your Gmail account. Verify your account with your phone number, create your account, and then sign in. Once you've signed in, you'll get a page like this. And this is the Gmail account that I've created for this tutorial. So guys, what we're going to do is set up a new email on your domain and then route all incoming inquiries from that new email account back into Gmail. Step two is creating an email account at your hosting provider. I'm currently with SiteGround to host my WordPress blog because it has close to 100% uptime, fast website loading speeds, and excellent customer service. I chose SiteGround from an SEO and server reliability because it's one of the best. And if you guys want to sign up to SiteGround, I'll also leave a link below so that you can get a discount to SiteGround hosting. Now, it doesn't matter if you're with Bluehost, HostGator, or any hosting provider. Your cPanel would look something like this. So we're going to scroll down, and under the heading Mail, you will click on Email Accounts. Then it will open up this page. Now, I'm going to create a new email account called info@amiibo.com. So let's just type that in, info. We can make a password and just generate a new password. Then for the limit, I'll put in 500 for now and click on create account. Right down here, you will see the new email I've just created. And another way of accessing your emails online is by going to yourdomain.com/webmail, enter in the new email address you created as well as the password, and then log in. Now, we're not going to log in and access our emails through this interface, so I'm going to close out of that. But I just wanted you to know there's another way to access your web email. So we'll close out of that and head back to our Gmail account. And what we're going to do is click on this gear icon and then click on See All Settings. Up on top, you want to click on Accounts and Import tab. And then step three is enabling Gmail to send from your custom email address. So in our case, we want our email info@amiibo.com to be sent from Gmail. Now, I don't like using the webmail interface that I showed you previously, and I like using Gmail's interface. So you can use Gmail to send and receive emails, and you'll be able to send emails using your custom domain directly from your free Gmail account. Under check mail from other accounts, you're going to click on add a mail account and then type in the email address you just created in your cPanel. Click on Next, leave it at Import Emails from My Other Account, POP3, click Next. For this section, you need to enter in your full email address. I'm going to paste in my password, all these details. You need to go to your Emails tab where you created your emails, click on More, and then Configure Email Client. Then you go under here and look at Secure SSL TLS Settings. These are the incoming server and outgoing server details that you need to add in your Gmail configuration. So for this example, POP3 port 995, that's what we want to add, and we want to use the incoming server. I'll change the POP server and the port will be 995. So we'll click on this, check, leave a copy of retrieved messages on the server, check on this, and then click on add account. Okay, so my email has been added to Gmail, and I would select, yes, I want to be able to send my email as info@amiibo.com, and then click on next. Now for my name, I could put Amy Customer Service and then leave it as treat as an alias, and then click on next step. Under send a mail through your SMTP server, that's going to be your outgoing server. So for me, it's 465. I'm going to paste in my SMTP server, which is located here. Leave my username at info@amiibo.com, and then this will be the password that I created for this email address. Once you've entered in your password, click on secure connection using SSL, and then click on add account. The next step is confirming verification and add your email address. So what Gmail will do is that it will send an email with a confirmation code to info@amiibo.com, and then you need to log in that using your webmail and click on the confirmation link or enter in the confirmation code. Let's log into amiibo.com webmail. I'll enter in my email and password again, click login. I'll click on a round cube. This is the confirmation email from Gmail. Click on that. And then I'm going to click on this link here and click confirm. Let's go back to this pop-up and then close window. Now we're going to go to the cogwheel settings. Click on see all settings under accounts and import. Scroll down and then click make default. Set the reply to always reply from default address at info@amiibo.com. Let's go to compose now and then type in a test email. Does this work? Then click send. Okay, so I can see here it says Amy Customer Service, which is the name that I've given it. And if I click on this, you can see here that the from address is info@amiibo.com, and it all works. So now you can use the Gmail interface and respond to customers or inquiries using your business domain and just manage everything through here. That's it, guys. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, hit that like button for me. Leave me a comment below if this worked for you. And until next time, have an amazing week and see ya.